terms like disability people or normal people. So this is the term of inclusive. So
I think it's very important issue for this thing, because all the people have right to enjoy the tourism place, like a beach maybe, like a resort, or yeah, a lot of places, right? A lot of places like tourism place, and of course a lot, I mean, all the people, although they have disability, they should have a good, what's the name, service, of course, from the provider of the place, the tourism place. I think it's very important, I think.
Have you some place in your place, in your country or in your regency, the tourism place?
You mean like, do I have the place that tourism place?
Yeah, and it for the disability.
I don't know about it actually, but I think maybe there is, but I have never been there before, I think. I mean, like, I never visited the place. But I think that there is the place like that, it does exist.
Mika, hello, are you there?
Yes, Bang Ojak, I'm here.
Okay, I think this topic is so interesting for you, right? Because I want to know about how Hong Kong live the same change. I mean that the facilities for the people with disabilities in tourism sector. So give me your experience.
Yeah, Hong Kong is a nice country. The government give everything is easy for disabilities. You know, whenever, for example, my grandpa, they want to go to hospital, they want to go to restaurant, they have their own taxi for disabilities. Also, Hong Kong have the one-off car only for disabilities. For example, they want to go to school or they want to go to work, so easily to call. So every time, whenever you want to go, just calling. Enough. And then whenever a blind person want to go to MTR or maybe tram like that, the Hong Kong have a rule only for disabilities. Everywhere, for example, at home, we want to go to market, Hong Kong have one of how can I say, garis untuk orang buta. How can I say, Bang Hutan?
Line for blind person.
Yeah, blind or blind person, so easily for disabilities go to anywhere. Also, whenever we have go to bus, you just call a number and you say from driver, I want to go to there. After that, driver will call you. This is Hong Kong people have a responsibility for disabilities.
Oh wow. So, I think it's include the tourism sector, right? So, what the tourism sector there?
Yeah, tourism sector also. Whenever you want to go, for example, in the Disneyland, for maybe a disabled person, they have a discount. Also, have one rule. For example, no need to waiting for a long time. So people will call you. You have own land to go to inside. For elderly, for pregnant person, for disabilities, they have own rule. For example, you sit in the where people will call you first. This is respect all the Hong Kong people. Hong Kong people are so disciplined. I hope Indonesia can follow or maybe just similar this Hong Kong person, because almost Indonesia don't want to wait, But for Hong Kong people, there without any without a commando, people will also wait. For example, you first, and I am number two. I will stay behind you. Never say wait a moment like that. No, Hong Kong people will how can I say, so disciplined. So anywhere with wherever you go to in the pariwisata or maybe in the market, in the mall, in the garden, people will give you land whenever you have disabilities. Thank you, brother.
Okay, oh wow. I think in Indonesia we have some tourism places there. Support for disability, some like in Ancol or in Bufan. There is online for disability, but yeah, it's just a little bit the tourism price in Indonesia, right? Because of that, I need to hear from the people here that what about in your country, what about in your places. So thank you for Miss Unica for your time. Maybe you can talk next. So let's move to who is he? Mr. Andy, right? Oh, Adam Malik. Hello, yes. Adam Malik.
Yes, Mr. Roger.
Okay, I have waiting you. So where have you been? That's fine.
Actually, I take care of my daughter.
Oh, so sorry.
Because my daughter is crying.
Okay. So, what about you, Adam Malik? How can call you, Adam or Malik?
You can call me Adam.
Adam, okay. So, Adam, what about you about this topic? Is your inclusivity in the tourism sector for disability?
Actually, in our country, especially for Indonesia, right, I think not really enough for give to this disability person, right? Because I think we can compare like another country, for example, a special place, what we call it. I think government should be give many signs for like this disability person, such as from toilet, right, or someone everything that for disability, because now we can see that from the disability person like blind people, I think they need what we call it special toilet, right, and then another also, because I think from actually with algorithm for disability, so we call it so little bit support from our government, actually we need more support from government, because we are the human, we have a human right, so we are equal with other people, even though that we are disability person, right? Because everyone have a right, so don't see from the person that cannot like us, like but no more people, right? But I think that from the government need support actually, because from the disability person, we actually they have right to get everything from our government. So,
correctly, I think some rules and law has revealed by the government about disability, that the practice for the some sectors, I think, so is so less from the government. So what about in your place? Is there the tourism place for and safe for disability?
Actually, on my city, South Sumatra, I think I never see about the tourism for disability people. Yeah, because I don't know exactly, because our government, because my city not really care about it, because I never see it, right? Because I see only maybe that, like, you know, the school only I see from the disability people, but for like other area, especially maybe like you say that in Ancol, right, in Jakarta, or other things that we can see it, but in my city, I never see it, in my city, I don't know exactly, because I never go alone in my city, maybe the Palembang, I never see it for myself, actually.
So what about we talk in the graveyard side of tourism or pilgrimage site? Have you your country or your region see the pilgrimage site for visiting? Have your region see the pilgrimage site or the graveyard site? Something like the ulama grave or some the character of the Indonesian nationalist grave. Ziarah,
Palembang have special grave, you know, we call it apa to the name in Palembang. Ziarah kubur, we call it in Palembang, right? So many people come to pray to meet the biggest we call it ulama in Palembang, right? So every people coming, maybe I don't know if they run 100 or 1,000 for visiting that grave. For every Israel Miraj, okay, mistaken that for the day, that moment happened.
So the place is safe for the disabilities or not?
I'm not sure that actually Mr. Ocha, actually for our country is not safe for disability people, because why? Actually we can see we not have a sign for disability people, right? I think what maybe only in Europe or another country like Japan or Singapore or Taiwan they have such a sign, right? You can see from the road, right? Right? No sign at all, right? It's hard to give access for the disability coming there actually. So super blind people, but maybe from the like focusing this dumb people or dumb or how to say English mouth, you can see speaking for it. And they can but for more they cannot write.
So muter.
Yeah. Muter, yeah. I think muter and it can come there, but for blind people cannot to reach there. Because the place is, you know, is the hill, right? I think it's not safe for blind people.
That according to you is need to increase some facilities for disabilities, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, we need to cover government to support all sign and the access for tourism people for disability actually, Mr. Roger.
Okay, thank you for your great your perspective and opinion. So we can talk next again. Okay, thank you. And we move to Mr. Andy. Hello, Mr. Andy.
Hello, Mr. Rochat. How are you?
I'm safe and sound. What about you?
I'm fine too. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Andy, so this topic is interesting for academic person like you. So, what about you about the inclusivity in sector of tourism for disabilities?
Okay, I think Indonesia has started to implement facilities for people with disabilities, especially in Medan City, where I come from. For example, in Medan, there are already sidewalk for the blind.
Oh wow.
Actually the sidewalk is for the parking of motorbikes and street vendors or PKL.
Indonesian core.
Yes, that.
This topic is very interesting for you, right?
Yes, sir.
So, yeah, Medan, where is the Medan part that has the sidewalk? All Medan or just in the town?
Or in the center of Medan, like Lapangan Merdeka, Merdeka Field, dan Balai Kota. Maybe about 30% of Medan.
Wow, it's so interesting. So what about in the cold sector of the tourism? Is there some tourism places that serve for disabilities in Medan? Some like
not yet. For example, like bus is still not for disability. So must be dikembangkan. What is still dikembangkan? Sorry. Ada? Just only sidewalk for the blind.
Okay, so is there that act for disabilities in the town square? Or just
town square?
Yeah, in town square, apa town square ya?
Town square. What is that, sorry? Town square.
Town square, how to say in Bahasa town square?
Town square. Town square.
I don't know about that.
Town square.
Home square is not like rumah kotak.
No. Alun-alun kota.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Home square. Okay. In Medan, there is a home square. The name is Lapangan Merdeka. And now is still rehabilitation. I think the leader of Medan is will build the town square for disability too, I think. But now is still in rehabilitation.
Okay. Okay. So what about in the mask? The Muhammadiyah mosque is safe for disabilities, but what about in the biggest mosque in the Medan? Is there access and facilities for disabilities?
I'm sorry, masker, topeng. What is the mask?
Masjid. Masjid, but yeah, tulisannya masjid ya.
Yeah. Mas, tulisannya masjid, bacanya mas ya.
Yeah.
Okay. Mas, I think in Medan, I ever saw the disabilities to take a prayer in Masjid, and there is like a bangku. What is bangku? Bangku. There is a bench for the disabilities. I think in the masjid is there is facilities for disabilities or tourism.
So it's all the mask or only?
No. Oh. Only maybe not much. Tidak banyak. No. In some masjid.
Okay. What about
me? I just saw like a bench, not just like that.
Okay. So what about the beach in Medan or yeah beach?
I think Medan is there is no beach because Medan is city.
Oh.
at the pinggiran, what is the near of Medan, maybe I think it's very less of facility for disabilities, because like maybe like toilet is not clean, so for we maybe very not recommended for the Medan, sir.
Okay, so when there is someone with disabilities, they want to get tourism in Medan, so we avoid it, yeah. We avoid it with him, because it's not there for disabilities.
No, because in Pasir, many of pariwisata in near of Medan, not Medan, Medan is still dikelola, still managed by masyarakat, by people.
Okay.
Not government. Government is very less. Sangat kurang.
Tiger boy. Okay, so interesting. So, what about the participation of the government from the people with disabilities in some sectors? Do they still in progress or just focus on another side and don't care about disabilities? Or how about the government?
The government is still in process. For example, when we antrian a queue to the office, there is the special place for disabilities.